Hey guys, welcome to another Cubite 3 tutorial. Now in this video I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make default parameters or arguments, whatever you guys call it. It's an argument, it's a parameter, it's all the same thing. So basically in the last tutorial I talked to you guys about the name, the grade, and of course the age. Now these are just random words I decided to use in my function. You can use whatever you want, but this is what I'm using, and these are my age and grades and names. So basically on this video I'm going to be showing you guys how to make default parameters so users don't actually have to write all this stuff every time you call the function. You make a default parameter for them. So on this video what I'm going to be doing is that I'm going to be making a default parameter, and to make a default parameter in Python you simply use the equal to sign. Now this is telling Python that you're setting a variable inside the function. So when I say my name, what did I say my name was? Okay, yeah, I need to copy all of this here. Let's just copy this. You guys know I have been having hard times copying stuff, so I just pray this goes well. Okay, one down, copy. Okay, I'm going there. Okay, let's just paste this. Okay, yeah, one down. Let's head to this part. I could just give my, okay, it's starting to freak me out again. Okay, yeah, I think I got that copied. I did. I used Ctrl C, paste. Okay, so I've got my grade down, one to go. And this, oh my god, this time is the age, so I'm gonna go slowly. Okay, I got 2000. Okay, slowly. If you've watched my previous tutorial, you know how this goes. Okay, so Ctrl C. Okay, yeah, this is done. So basically, I have made the default parameter here. So every time this function calls in, we do not have to write stuff like this again. So all we have to do now in this case is say, print my name is this, I am in grade this, I am age years old. So since we've made the default parameters here, all we have to do here is, since we are now trying to make the user type in stuff all over again, all we have to do now is say the name, the age, and the grade. So just think about it as you're making a function with just, I think, a method, but this time it's not a method because methods are fixed names, but this time you're making the name, age, and grade. I don't know why, oh my god, Jesus Christ, they just keep coming up on my tutorials. Get off my screen, please, get off my screen. My goodness, who is this nigga? Get off. Damn. Okay, sorry for that guys, I am really sorry. So since I have made the functional parameters on default, every time I call this function name I just put these three stuffs here, the name, the age, and the grade. Okay, I think grade comes first. Whatever you want, if you put it this way it still works, you can try that out. Okay, let me just run it this way to just clear you guys on my own conscience. So let's just run this way. Now this is going to work fine, but I think the age is coming first. It's coming second. What? Are you seriously kidding me right now? Okay, I can see what's going on here. Now the reason why this is not working is because we've already set the default values in this place. The grade is 76, the age is 2000, the name is Desmond, obviously the best nigga ever. So all we have to do now is remove all these values from here, so we don't have to keep writing them again since we already set the default values. So every time we call this function, the parameters inside, which is in default, automatically reads all this inside here and just runs the code for us inside the function, which is all this from this point down to this point. So let's save this our code and let's run it. Fingers crossed, see the output, and voila. Boom, in your face Python, my name is Desmond, the best nigga ever, I am in grade 76, and I am 2000 years old. So what this does now is, since it runs all our code very fine, perfectly fine, We all have the about me function running perfectly fine, sleekly on your PC. So this is how some functions you see in Python, which does not have any parameters visible, work. They all have their parameters made by default. So every time you call the function here, automatically gets printed out. So imagine the print statement in Python having the print parentheses here and having a close parenthesis. And when you run your code, it just prints out whatever is inside this parentheses for you. So that's how the print statement was made, but obviously not with print, because you can't make a print function with a print. So this was how functions were made. They were made by passing in different lines of code inside of this. So that's all for this video, guys. Please like this video, hit that like button, hit it, smash it, hit it very, very hard, and do not forget to subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Thank you for watching. It's Desmond.